It's time for The Frangie Show on 1010 XL 92.5 FM.
Hey, welcome in. Glad you're along for the ride. Frangie and Carline, JJ LaSelva. Today's new drug is day one of the Masters, kids. You like the Masters? You get excited on day one?
It's fantastic. Absolutely, I'm excited. How about Bryson DeChambeau, 7-under? Is scorching.
He got in a good lift today, I think. He got some protein in the body, I think, is what happened. Right. And then playing very well. I love the golf. I love our friend Lee Smith, by the way, the executive director of the Players Championship, our golf analyst. We'll be here in about 15 minutes or so to talk a little bit about the details of this. But you know what? What do you think of DeChambeau? Do you like DeChambeau?
No, I don't, because he cost me a loser Monday many years ago at the Memorial. And because he played the
– I love the –
It was the worst played single hole I've ever seen. He had his ball up on a fence and decided to try and hit it.
We broke
his club, should have broken his elbow, and made about a 9 on a par 4.
We were Brucci's Pizza.
Yes,
if I remember right.
We were.
Sitting outside, had a little putting contest going. And I remember, again, the pain I felt, not from the effort of putting or from eating way too much of that fantastic pizza, but from laughing so hard at how angry you were at Bryson DeChambeau. It was one of my happy – that might have rivaled Dustin Johnson.
Yeah, because at the time, he was like the hottest player on the planet. So it wasn't just that – I got saddled with the last pick and I picked kind of went had to go out on a limb. It already used a bunch of guys. This was like he's the hottest player in the world. And for whatever reason, I guess maybe I'd lost the one before.
Right.
But it was like clearly he was the one to take. It's typical golf. It's whoever is the guy that you absolutely can't not select is the one that melts down. But it was the manner in which I understand sometimes you're just going to have a bad day. He was just such a moron and how he played that hole.
Remember that?
That it was unforgivable to me that he would just give away his tournament on a idiotic decision. So anyway, I'm not a huge fan.
What I like best of you is you don't hold grudges.
I move on.
The many quality traits you have.
I will not be pulling for Bryson DeChambeau to win this event. I mean, I appreciate how magnificent he's playing. I mean, to be 7-under is obviously sensational. He's obviously a wonderful talent. He won the 2020 U.S. Open. So, but I will say he has faded since. That U.S. Open win did not catapult him to really anything of note after. And then even when he joined LIV, it was sort of like he was one of the more afterthought kind of guys. And obviously since he went to LIV, no one knows what he's done. So anyway, I mean, we'll see if he can keep it going. But this is brilliant golf today. Certainly it's soft because of all the rain that came through. And Bryson DeChambeau is certainly taking advantage.
Yeah, 3 clear of the field as we speak. Danny Willett, Ryan Fox among those behind him at 4. Victor Hovland at 3.
Good Shepherd. To see Hovland playing well.
Yeah, he is playing very well. But again, 3-shot lead, at least as we speak, 4:03 on Thursday. For Bryson DeChambeau. The news of the day, by now, if you follow sports, O.J. Simpson, dead at the age of 76, died of cancer, says his family. Was that the – and now that the story is over, once and for all over, was that still the most bizarre story, certainly one of the most bizarre stories of an American sports hero in our lifetime?
It's if not far and away number one in my lifetime.
There's other American sports heroes who have fallen, but none like that. It was one of the most bizarre. I was thinking about this today. The book, the last chapter of the book was today. O.J. Simpson, again, has died. Died of cancer, again, says his family, at the age of 76. But O.J. Simpson was beloved before it all. O.J. Simpson was arguably the greatest running back of all time. Certainly, other than Jim Brown, would have had more votes in the common populace than anybody. He went from being a great, not good, great football player, Heisman Trophy winner, first guy to rush for 2,000 yards, you know the drill, to being so well-liked, charismatic, on television with NBC Sports as a sideline reporter, ran through airports as the Hurt spokesman, gigantic hit in the Naked Gun movies. I mean, this was a beloved figure who became even more beloved after he quit playing, and then wow. It remains one of the most bizarre stories in the history of American sport. It really does.
It really does. I was having lunch with our good friend Holt Harrell today, and we were talking about it. We had just gotten out of high school when this happened. I had just started like summer B at Florida. Literally, it might have been my first or second day on campus, okay. Like before even classes had started. And we were talking about it today, and it really, for I think our generation, it was the first insight into the revelation that sometimes your favorite athlete can have a side to them that you just have no idea about. That as great as somebody can be on the field, as great as somebody can be, as a comedic actor, as he certainly was in The Naked Gun, and as beloved as he was, there can be a side to these people that you just do not see. And he was the personification of that. Because, I mean, for people that are too young to really remember didn't live through it, he was absolutely beloved. It'd be hard for me to think of maybe Charles Barkley.
Right.
Would be kind of like it'd be like kind of if this happened to Charles Barkley. But even like Barkley at least has some kind of a edge.
Right.
Like
he had none.
OJ had none. I mean, he was just you had the beaming smile and tremendous personality, and everybody, you know, basically just really looked up to him. And it was shocking. I mean, it was absolutely shocking how it played out when the murders took place. Initially, it wasn't that big of a story until you got about 24, 36 hours into it, and you started to pick up on that the police think OJ may have had something to do with this. And then obviously the Bronco chase and everything, and then the overwhelming amount of evidence. It was stunning. I mean, to this day, it's certainly the most unbelievable story that I can remember.
I do want to report, by the way, that Tiger Woods now on pace to shoot 72 under for the Masters.
I like it.
In case you want to know, he just birdied number one. So that would be the pace if you're wondering about a pace.
I think it'll hold.
You remember, we all remember where we were. I was at a restaurant, the old Sundog Diner, with my wife, with Jack O'Brien, our friend Jacko, and his then wife, having dinner. We had dinner at Chizu, which was a Japanese steakhouse at the beach, and then had gone down to the Atlantic Beach area and were having drinks during the NBA playoffs. Suzanne and me and Jack and his wife, and couldn't believe what we were watching, the Bronco chase. So yeah, so and by the way, the Barkley comparison is a good one. Other than as great as Barkley was, Jordan was, I mean, Simpson was way more Jordan than he was Barkley.
Yes.
O.J. Simpson, O.J. Simpson, until it all happened, was roundly considered among the best two or three running backs in the history of the sport. Jim Brown is probably first, and at the time, O.J. probably was just ahead of Gale Sayers when he came in. A lot of running, the Barry Sanders and Emmitt Smiths and Eric Dickersons and all came along afterwards, AP. But at the time, I would say roundly considered, along with Jim Brown, best running back in the history of the sport. Back when running back was cool. Back when running back seemed almost as important as quarterback.
Was the star.
Yeah, that's right. Certainly right there with the quarterback.
And,
you
know, obviously he had a brilliant collegiate career as well. And, you know, again, the Barkley comparison is the only one I can think of. But even Charles Barkley, I mean, O.J. Simpson appeared in a lot of movies. I mean, everyone knew who O.J. Simpson was.
Right.
There's probably still people that don't really know who Charles Barkley is.
Correct.
But I would say O.J. Simpson, everyone knew who O.J. Simpson was.
Now every athlete is in every commercial, but it wasn't like that back then. When O.J. was running through airports for Hertz, that was – everybody talked about that. When he was – the Naked Gun movies, everybody talked about his role there. Everybody talked about the fact that he'd made his way into TV. And again, most importantly, when he ran for 2,000 yards, I can still remember the broadcast on – I think it was the Bills Network – when it was against the Jets, I want to say, when he got there, and the Bills broadcaster said, I hope we realize what we have just witnessed in the history of the game, someone rushing in. Was it a 14-game schedule?
I think it was.
It wasn't 12, but I think it was 14.
It was 14,
yeah. It was 14. So pretty amazing. Anyway, O.J. dead today, and then everything that happened afterwards. I mean, the lives that it spawned. Nobody knew Johnny Cochran or Robert Kardashian or – right, I mean,
Kato Kaelin.
Kato, all of them. I mean, they. There was a whole new Marsha Clark. There was a whole new
Lance Ito, judge.
Right. I mean, there were memes and jokes about all of them. You know, who had the dancing Itos? What was that? Was that that wasn't Saturday Night Live
or
remember. Something?
Yeah.
But it was amazing. I mean, it was the whole world that was spawned from the murder of Nicole Brown.
It honestly still today is a joke that if somebody made it, a reference to it in a movie or in a stand-up, like, it would resonate today.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a story that I don't think has ever fully gone away. And we've seen documentaries that, you know, we had the People versus O.J. Simpson that was released 3 or 4 years ago that's outstanding.
Outstanding.
If you haven't ever watched that, I don't know that culturally we've had anything that's struck the chord that case struck.
Yeah, and Sarah Paulson as Marsha Clark.
Oh yeah,
was amazing.
No doubt about it.
I mean, that was absolutely amazing. So I don't think people realize the significance of it. So anyway, the end of an era, the final chapter of the book. O.J. Simpson dead at the age of 76. And I'm telling you, when I saw it. And then I saw all the emotions that came from it. You know, it was the most bizarre response to a tweet about someone who had died, ever. You know, I mean, it really was. I mean, the pictures of Fred Goldman, you saw those?
Oh yeah,
they were all over Twitter. I mean,
absolutely.
It was just one of the most bizarre things.
The guy killed his son.
Yeah, I mean, right. I mean, and Fred stayed in the forefront, to for that reason.
Yeah, he's 82 now.
Yeah. So is Fred Goldman 82?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So O.J. lived 30 years afterward. Yeah. So
yeah.
Hard to believe stuff. So anyway, O.J. Simpson gone at the age of 76. Let's talk about more pleasant things. Let's talk a little bit about golf. JJ, fire it up.
Time now for the tour update with Players Championship Executive Director Lee Smith.
Keep an eye on this one.
Presented by Sunshine Turf, the highest quality artificial turf at affordable prices.
And we thank our friends from Sunshine Turf for sponsoring the Golf Report with Lee Smith. You can call Caleb Smith at 904-892-0580. You'll really like Caleb. He did so much work at our Bregan Baseball Complex, and we're proud of that and proud of the work he did. And listen, everyone's putting artificial turf greens in their backyards these days. They're doing things for their kids, areas by the pool. Nobody does a better job than Caleb. If you've even thought about it, shame on you if you don't get him out there to give you a bid. He's a designer. He does a great job. That's Sunshine Turf at 904-892-0580. Lee Smith is here. You never thought OJ would be your opening act, did you? You never saw that coming, did you? Illustrious career, never saw that coming.
You know, it's funny. Well, I shouldn't say funny. my only real interaction with him was he moved out to Las Vegas while I was the GM at TPC Summerlin is when he moved out there.
Okay.
And he was going to join a club. And we knew he was going to join a golf club, so we had prepared as to what that response might be should it happen. And I won't divulge what our response was,
but we never had to
deal with it. He ended up joining a club across town. So
he was an avid golfer, so
big time.
But that's a really interesting story. You had to prepare for in the event that yours was a club you tried to join.
Yeah, because, you had to take into consideration your staff, the rest of your members, the stakeholders of the club when you make that decision. But at the same time, what are the reasons for not access? So you're, bouncing all of those things around with all the stakeholders. Yeah, it was
interesting stuff.
Yep.
right. Sorry. Hey, good to see you. How are you?
Doing great.
Doing great. I do want to report that Tiger Woods is on pace to shoot 72 under.
I love that.
I don't like seeing him walking in pine straw.
Yeah, that's the pace. Looks like he hit one into the straw after birdieing number one. The Masters is on. What's the Masters mean to you? I mean, is it for it? It's golf royalty, obviously, for any of us. But for someone that's been in the industry your entire life, what's it mean to you?
I'll tell you, it's an event that when you play golf, it's and you're growing up with it, that you want to watch and you don't miss you wake up in the morning, you feel what a leader might feel like, because she's like, I got to wait all the way till 3 o'clock, or you know, as a kid when they were only showing the back nine and all those types of things, it was such an important event. Now, on kind of the management side, you respect how unapologetically themselves they are, and you know, they don't compromise. All the stakeholders row in the same direction. There's, you know, everybody's at least on the surface,
right.
The decision making is, you know, all going in the same direction, and it's certainly hard to not respect everything that they've achieved. But you know, it means a ton for golf. It's, you know, I think sometimes what a lot of people, I think, maybe don't understand in the landscape of professional golf is, you know, they are not a governing body. They without other than their prominence in the game of golf, they really don't make any decisions, but they do make some decisions,
right?
Just because how important that event is, you know, in the landscape of golf.
Pretty much, they control the decision making. Yeah, I agree with that.
Absolutely. Lee, in terms of the conditions, obviously we had a lot of rain come through. We can tell by the flagsticks there's considerable wind. Is it an easier course, you would think, because of the moisture, or is that wind enough to where it's going to bother some guys?
Well, I think the wind's the driver, Hayes. Interesting when you listen to how some of the players have talked about their preparation coming up to the week, is that the firmness of the property was significantly harder on a Monday and on a Tuesday and on a Wednesday than typical, maybe, there, because they had prepared for this rain. And so it'll be interesting to hear, you know, how soft it really is based on, you know, I think I heard a couple of guys that were talking about it was browning on Tuesday and on Wednesday, because I think they were preparing and have the opportunity to do that, to prepare. And a lot of golf tournaments do, you know, obviously look forward that, hey, if we're going to get an inch of rain on Thursday, Tuesday and Wednesday are going to look a little different, so that our total, you know, moisture. It'll be interesting to see, you know, how soft it really, really did play after rain like that.
That's an excellent point, because they knew that storm was coming.
Absolutely.
Right, so they're prepared.
Yeah.
For people that don't know about Augusta National, tell them about it. Well, we all know Amen Corner, and we all know we all know the pines and how it looks and how green, but challenges of the golf course, the toughest part of the golf course, just the golf part of it.
I think one thing that you hear, let's say from a spectator standpoint first, I think one thing that you hear is when you see it on TV, what comes to life when you're on that property is the undulations, and really how big an uphill shot or how drastic an uphill or a downhill shot is. And when you get there and you walk down number 10 from the tee to the green, or you walk number eight up number 18, you know, you're out of breath.
Right.
I mean, it's a significant uphill climb. And I think the undulations, not only with an entire hole, but on those greens, you know, is significantly more enhanced when you get there in person. You know, from a player's standpoint, I think Jack Nicklaus probably says it best, that each round, if you hit six good shots at the right time, the tournament can be yours. And he talks about those six shots being the tee shot at 2, the second shot at 11, the tee shot at 12, both shots on 13, and then your second shot on 15. And if you pull off those six shots over four rounds, that's 24 shots, you're going to make a lot of birdies. You're not going to make the big number where a lot of people make the big number. And I think that makes a lot of sense.
And
obviously, he's won it a couple times, so I'm gonna trust.
He would know. But it's interesting. You in that description, he and you ran all through Amen Corner.
Yep.
I mean that tells you the importance of Amen Corner, because they're all involved. You know, of the six, three of them are involved in that description. Great description.
It really is. I'd never heard it
never
broken
heard
down
either.
Like that. But that is excellent insight into
Yeah, those
how to claim the green jacket.
Well, you figured, you know, obviously the par fives are where you got to make some hay. I mean, look at a guy like Bryson, who a while ago had said par was 67 or 68 or whatever his number was.
Right.
That hasn't necessarily panned out with every one of his rounds. But if you hit those six shots well, you're not making a big number on 11 or 12, and you're going to birdie 2 and 13 and 15. You know, there's 3 under. And then you manage your way around the others. I think it makes a lot of sense.
What about Bryson DeChambeau? Can he keep this going? We don't see the live guys. It's not like we see him every week like we do our tour guys. Can he keep this going?
I'll tell you, when he's on, you know, his A-plus game, there's probably not many that can touch him. It just seems like, you know, he hasn't had it all that much. Obviously shooting 58, I think, one time at Greenbrier on a tour golf course a couple years ago. But certainly, I mean, you want to talk about a tactician, you know, his art is the fact that he uses so much science to play the game.
Right,
you know,
right.
Every one of his irons is 6-iron length. If you've ever had the ability to look at his golf clubs, they're about as big around as that water, his grips
right.
are about as big around as that water bottle. And, you know, imagine in your own game if every iron was the same length and the grips were as big. But he believes in the math and the science that,
wow.
that he's put together, and obviously it's worked for him.
Wow.
What kind of challenge will Tiger have from a physical standpoint of playing today but not completing the round and then having to come back tomorrow and finish but also have that morning tee time?
Yeah, I think it's always, you know, it's good for him when he can – package two rounds together in an afternoon and a morning, you know, and then it's not bad when obviously he can play in the morning on Thursday and recover Thursday afternoon and then have a whole morning to recover Friday. So there's goods and bads with it. I think the bad part, Hayes, is that if it's soft, which again, I don't think it is, it makes that walk just that little harder. And then however many holes he gets done today, you know, anytime, I think for him, he would tell you that if he's got to play more than 18 holes, that's just more tax on the body than he really wants to put on it in one day.
Yeah, Bob Herrick was with us this week, and he said, hitting the golf shots isn't the problem.
No.
It's getting golf shot to golf shot, a walk in the golf course. What are your expectations for Tiger? I mean, I know we've started, but what are your expectations?
Look, the only expectation that would keep you from thinking that with his A game he could compete is rust. And that's, you know, talked about some of the other live guys too, that maybe they just haven't played as much. But, you know, look, there's something about look at a guy like Danny Willett. I mean, we haven't heard a ton from him, but driving down Magnolia Lane, it's – I think somebody said it on TV that this event, not only allowing you to play for as long as you can, but this event treats its past champions, and it's not as much physical, but mental. You drive down Magnolia Lane, your game comes back.
Yeah.
And so I think the experience and the memories that Tiger has, I think he's got to get off to a good start, and obviously birdieing the first hole isn't bad. And you know, get to where he can just put a red number after the first day. I think it's like almost like a Cinderella hanging around in the NCAA tournament. Like you want to put them away in the first half, because the longer they get to hang around, the more nervous you are and the more confident they are.
Great to see Hovland having a good day today at 4 under right now. You know, we talked about the swing change, and you know, sometimes that can really have long-term crippling effects for a player. But good to see him finding some form today.
Absolutely. He's, you know, he became a star after last year's FedEx Cup. And then he, I think, is another mathematician and science, and he wants to get everything that he can, not only out of his golf game, but of every expert that's around him. And I think, you know, Joe Mayo was his previous instructor. And I believe he moved on to somebody, and then now Dana Dahlquist, which you know is they're not teaching a massive amount of different things to him, but I think he wants to get everything that he can out of everybody, and I mean that in a positive way. And so it probably just is confidence, and he's, you know, had some success on this golf course, so some familiarity and those types of things. But it is, I think, for you know, stars to arrive and find themselves at the top of the leaderboard, I think is great.
Lee Smith with us, the executive director of the Players Championship. It is our golf report. It's brought to you by our friends at Sunshine Turf, the best in the business. If you want a turf putting green in your backyard or around your pool, the best turf people, my friends at Sunshine Turf, Caleb Smith and company. Frank Frangie, Hayes Carlion with you. The when you watch the Masters, do you care if it's low? Do you care if it's – would you rather 16 win it? Would you rather 4 win it? Do you care about that?
No, I don't. I like the golf, and I tend to work towards middle teens, I think, is a really, really exciting brand of golf.
Okay.
I think that allows for eagles to be had and putts to go in and all of those types of things. But then at the same time, you know, you're going to see a little bit of carnage around 11 and 12 or, you know, those shots that spin back off of 15 or whatever it might be. I think that's also part of the game that a golf course rewards really, really good shots and penalizes bad ones. I think that's easy to say and it sounds like common sense, but I think sometimes golf courses and some events are prepared in a way that I can hit a really good shot and it doesn't get rewarded. And I think this golf course does a really, really good job of that.
Let's say Scottie Scheffler goes into Sunday with a 3-shot lead and then he gets the call that Meredith is going into labor. Do you think he will walk off the course?
I'll tell you, if it's his decision, I think he would. I gotta believe that Meredith wouldn't allow him to do it.
Yeah, that's right.
I gotta believe that he would say, she would say, give me the phone.
Right.
You ain't leaving, okay? Win that tournament, and you know we'll name baby Augusta or something. But I think, I think if it's his decision, he might. But if it's hers, there's no way.
Lee, if he wins this one, and I know we always want to canonize the latest guy, and I'm the guiltiest of the guilty. I think I've made Jordan Spieth and JT and all of them the best golfer I've ever seen after Tiger. We're all guilty of that, and I'm the worst. But if he wins this one, after the way he played this year, it's hard not to think that he's the closest thing to Tiger since Tiger, isn't it?
That's tough, Frank, because I agree with you to the point that he would be the closest thing right now.
Yeah.
But I think I mentioned one of the last couple times that we were together in the post-players press conference when they asked about a comp to Tiger.
Right.
You know, his point was, I've been number one in the world for however long. I've only got 11 years to go to reach Tiger's, you know, level of dominance.
Yeah.
So certainly I think he would be today's pick. With his consistency, you know, ball striking. And, I mean, you know, the better conditions, high winds, you know, even though it's an added variable, it certainly rewards a guy that can ball strike his way around the golf course. But it's always going to be tough to put him in a group with Tiger or Jack or whatever, knowing what they've done. I mean,
and how long they did it.
He's got one. Tiger's got 15.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? There's a long ways to go.
How cool is it seeing Jack Nicklaus, Gary Player, Tom Watson, that ceremonial? You know, obviously we had Arnie for so many years. How important is that to the legacy of the game and teaching it to, you know, young fans that this might be the first Masters they're watching?
I think it's certainly a really, really cool tradition that they do. I think when I was watching it quickly, they all three hit the fairway this morning, which, you know, that's always cool for fans to see. I think what may be more important than that is having them around an event like this and allowing the younger players to, you know, have access to those three champions that have won there so many times, and, you know, to talk, hey, how do you play this shot on 11 or where do you aim at 12? And I heard Jack say, I think this week, that you can never draw it into number 12. And I mean, without playing there under those conditions and whatever, that doesn't make any sense, I think, to most people. But he just says a draw doesn't respond the way that a cut into that 12th hole does. And I think that's just an interesting take from a player's perspective that nobody would know unless you spoke to Jack and got that kind of insight.
I'm still – it's, and we talk about this every week, and we all talk about it off air. It's still weird for me that Koepka and DeChambeau and Mickelson and Bubba all show up now with their long pants on and – You know what I mean? I can't get there. And this isn't a. I mean, I'm way more. I'm pro tour and anti live because just that's where we live and what. But it still feels weird for me. It doesn't feel normal, even watching the Masters. You like that?
Yeah, I mean, you know, look, they've played a few events this year.
Right.
I think, but I personally think that too much has been made of this rest versus rust thing. I think. You know, there's some players that love to play their way into to a major and play the week before, you know, at San Antonio. And there's others that like to take a week or two off and sharpen their game at home. I don't know that that's any different than these guys. Certainly to watch TV and see faces that maybe you haven't seen for a while on TV is a little bit weird. But I think we're in for a great, great tournament, and I don't believe you prepare the way that you want to prepare, and whether it's playing four times or Tiger only playing one round or, you know, playing 2 weeks in a row right into a major, if that's what's best for you, I think that's, you know, that's the way you should do it.
All right. Well, I told Hayes this yesterday. I play a lot of golf, and I wear shorts, and I'm okay with me wearing shorts. But tell those guys to put their dang pants on. Put your pants on if you're playing golf on TV.
Yeah.
Does it bug you?
Well, it's funny that I mean, as a PGA professional, if I go play an event, I got to put pants on.
That's right. Put your pants
absolutely.
On, for God's sake.
No.
How was the Final Four? I know you went to the Final Four. Tell people why you went to the Final Four.
It was awesome. My high school friend that's a great friend of mine, Kareem Richardson, won a national title with Louisville in 12. But he's an assistant coach at NC State, so it was a special one for us to go and be able to watch them play in a crazy run and you know, we talked about it, winning nine elimination games basically in a row. That's, you know, that just doesn't happen. And then catching up with him afterwards, I've been around him at conference tournaments when he was a head coach and seeing what the finality of the end of the season means to him. And this one, he certainly wasn't happy about it, but I think they were proud of the fact that to date they had kept Purdue, you know, to their lowest point total of the year. I know UConn was a little even less than that in the championship game, but it was a special one for us to go and hang out with him and have a good time. And he was going to come to the players
right.
to support me, but he had other plans.
He got busy.
he had other plans of winning five in a row in the ACC tournament.
Lee Smith from the Players' Championship, our golf analyst. Thanks for stopping by.
Absolutely. Thank you.
As always, brought to you by Sunshine Turf, my friend Caleb Smith. Call him again, 904-892-0580. Back in a moment. Stay with us.
The Frangie Show from the Harrell & Harrell Studio. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
Now, a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. A former U.S. Open champion has brought a flamethrower to the second nine at Augusta.
Bryson DeChambeau, 6-under in the lead. He's putting for birdie at the 17th green. In the back right portion of the green, he's made another one! Bryson is 7-under par through 17 holes. What a first round for Bryson as he goes to the 18th tee.
Taylor Zarzur, the call on SiriusXM. 5 birdies in a 6-hole stretch for DeChambeau. Now playing 18. He put his tee shot into the fairway bunker left of the fairway. Was able to splash out onto the green. And a nice lag putt for DeChambeau from about 40 feet. Bryson should be able to tap in from there for par. It would be a 7-under 65 for DeChambeau. He's got a 3-shot lead right now. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
Now your ideas don't have to wait. Now they have everything they need to come to life. Dell Technologies and Intel are creating technology that loves ideas, loves expanding your business, evolving your passions. We push what technology can do, so great ideas can happen right now. Find out how to bring your ideas to life at Dell.com. Welcome to Now.
Traveling? Volunteering? Spending time with family? What's your retirement look like? With income planning from Fidelity Wealth Management, a dedicated advisor can help you grow and protect your wealth. They'll look at your full financial picture and help you create a flexible strategy that considers things like market conditions and healthcare expenses, so you can stop worrying about the future and enjoy whatever comes next. Visit fidelity.com/income planning. Investment minimums apply. Fidelity Brokerage Services member NYSE SIPC.
Tiger Woods has played only 24 holes of competitive golf this year as he manages his surgically repaired ankle and knee and back. A lesser man would need a steel-toed boot to protect that ankle. Woods, the 15-time major champion, opens with a birdie at one, only the second time since 2000. He started the Masters with a birdie, but Tiger is in the pine straw at two and right next to a loblolly pine off the tee. Let's check the leaderboard. Sponsored by Dell. Dell Technologies pushes what technology can do so your great ideas can happen right now. Learn more at Dell.com. It's Bryson DeChambeau on top, 7-under, just about to tap in for par at 18 to wrap up a 65 today. Danny Willett, Ben Ahn, and Victor Hovland at 4-under, 3-back. Willett in the clubhouse, just 6 months removed from shoulder surgery. Hovland heading to the second nine. He closed out the first nine with 3 straight birdies. Ben Ahn is through 15 holes. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
If you need an insurance agent, I'll recommend the best guy in town, State Farm agent Craig Dewhurst. Call him at 940-9740. Really good guy, really good agent. Life insurance, homeowners, automotive, you name it, he'll handle it for you. Tell him what you need. He'll assess your whole situation. What kind of coverage do you need? How much coverage? What should your deductible be? What do you make and how does it fit your cost and your rates? You will love dealing with Craig, what a nice guy he is, and how he'll help you get the right answers. The best in the business. Craig Dewhurst from State Farm, 940-9740. Hi, folks. I'm Frank Frangie for Ricketts Electric. Now, any good lineup needs power. When I needed a power connection for our new walk-off charities baseball park, I found the perfect partner in Ricketts Electric. You're going to love these guys, I'm telling you. The Ricketts family has been providing commercial and residential electric service for years. So call my buddy Zach Ricketts today at 904-320-5960, and you can find them on Facebook as well. You will trust them. That's Ricketts Electric, the city's best power connection. Call them today at 320-5960.
I'm Holt Harrell with Harrell & Harrell. Choosing a law firm after an accident is an important decision. With so many messages, we know it can all sound the same. At Harrell & Harrell, we believe what sets us apart is our commitment to you. We'll help you find doctors to get you better, and we'll work hard to maximize any recovery. Visit our website and look at our reviews to see how we've helped people just like you make this important decision. Harrell & Harrell. Offices, Jacksonville.
It doesn't get any better than live country music. Enjoy Daryl Ray at Players Grill Miramar this Friday at 7 p.m. with discount cocktails while the local star rocks out. Players Grill Miramar, where the neighborhood meets.
This is my bar.
A bucket of balls and free advice from PGA pros. Brunch with the Tour.
What's this about?
Dan, Jeff, and PGA Tour insiders.
It's a bit simplistic, but basically correct.
Brought to you by Clearwater Irrigation. 8:30 Tuesday morning on 1010XL.
Best bet is number one. That's right. Best bet Jacksonville, Orange Park, and St. Augustine have one card poker. The fastest and easiest card game to learn and play. Play one card at a time, and the highest card wins even money. If the card values are the same, it's time for war. Just like the game you remember. You must be 18 years or older to play. More at bestbetjacks.com. That's bestbetjacks.com.
Certainly facing challenging economic times, I can't speak for all of us, but for me, comforting to know my money is in good hands with ITP Partners. Take it here for ITP Partners, Jacksonville guys, taking care of my Jacksonville money. I'll admit it, I don't understand a ton about the economy, higher interest rates, 401ks, but I do know as I move closer to retirement, I continue to watch my money grow. Thanks to Chris Bryan, Jeff Hartman, Reagan Wright, Dan Abel, and Reed Wingate. Get in the game, guys. ITP Partners, always there to help. For more info, Chris at ITPPartners.com or call 904-312-9751.
David Lane here again for Southeast Orthopedic Specialists. After several surgeries for age-old issues, mainly my back and shoulders, there's no doubt that Southeast Orthopedic Specialist is my sustaining resource for living pain-free. Take it from me, and I'm being really honest here, there's no better orthopedic facility here in Jacksonville.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Your cooling system isn't working. Maybe somebody showed up with a portable electronic device. Then they discussed with you what your options are. Maybe they gave you an estimate that seems like an awful lot of money. What's the smart thing to do? When the situation merits a second opinion, get a Mike Merritt opinion. Yes, the Mike Merritt Comfort Team shows up with hand tools. We've never been able to fix an air conditioning problem with a tablet. Mike Merritt has been the trusted name for more than 30 years because there's never any hocus pocus. The Merritt team will walk you through the diagnostic steps up close and personal and show you exactly what you need. And the Mike Merritt price is likely to be far less because there's never an overtime charge, and the Merritt team doesn't work on commission. So remember, when it comes to the health of your cooling system, a second opinion can only help, and a Mike Merritt opinion can save you money. Florida license CACO 50384.
I'm with Greg from Cycles of Jacksonville, and the summer sun is just begging us to get out and ride. And Honda's got every level of rider in mind, don't they?
They do. They've got Honda scooters. They've got the mini motos, great for the beach. They've got the big, heavy Goldwing, great for taking something cross-country. Or they got the Weekend Warrior bikes, too. We got them all in the showroom.
Yeah, the real cool thing about it is you can log on to cyclesofjacksonville.com or just cruise on by and check you out.
Absolutely. We got them on the showroom, ready to roll.
On Atlantic, near Regency, Cycles of Jacksonville.
If you're a business owner and want to learn about federal, state, or local government contracts, plan to attend a free online webinar April 23rd. The Florida Apex Accelerator, in partnership with UNF, provides expert guidance and consultations at no cost. The Apex Accelerator program can make selling to the government less complicated. To attend the free Coffee and Contracting webinar April 23rd, register at unf.edu/sbdc. Then select Training and Event tab.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Glad you're with us on a Stanley Pools Thursday, my friends from Stanley Pools since 1988. The pool company, the pool builders of Jacksonville. My friends at Stanley Pools. Frangie and Carline, JJ LaSalva with you. Always good to see our friend Lee Smith. Well, he's a great golf analyst, isn't he?
That's becoming one of my favorite segments.
Yeah, he really, really understands the
game. I mean,
I love the
Nicklaus, you know, talking about the
great
the pressure points of the six shots.
Yeah, so Lee does a great job. It's always great to catch up with Lee, and he really knows the game. So a lot of other things to talk about today. We'll get the headlines in just a couple minutes, quick segment here. But I saw that Scott Drew is staying.
Yeah.
Scott Drew is staying at Baylor, and – apparently now they've gone through the Jay Wright, no thank you. Danny Hurley, no thank you. Billy Donovan apparently said, I'm committed to Chicago. I'm not convinced he's off. He's not any.
Yeah, I think he's become the betting favorite.
He is the betting favorite, so I'm not convinced of that. But then I saw a list where if it's not him and they don't go after Nate Oates because of the $18 million buyout or he's just not their guy, then they move on to the second-tier candidates. Did you see this list, Bruce Pearl, others?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is Shaka Smart on it?
He's not, but Todd Golden was.
It doesn't surprise.
It said second tier candidates.
And won at Rupp this year.
Yeah, he did.
I mean, he's young. Don't get me wrong. But I think if you were looking at it, if you're at this point in your search,
right,
where let's say the top three or four guys have turned you down, I think that guy's a star.
This thing,
I mean,
said,
you give Todd Golden the Kentucky program?
The ESPN story said the story of Drew staying, even though he had visited Lexington to check it out, he and his family. It pretty much says Jay Wright and Danny Hurley turned him down. Billy Donovan has publicly said he is publicly committed to Chicago, and they're in the play-in tournament. We'll see what that means. Alabama, I'm reading from the story now. Alabama's Nate Oates also released a statement saying he's not interested. So then the next sentence in this ESPN story, names such as Auburn's Bruce Pearl, Illinois' Brad Underwood, Xavier's Sean Miller, Florida's Todd Golden, Iowa State's T.J. Otzelberger and BYU's Mark Pope would appear to emerge as the next tier.
Wow.
Now, Pope played there.
I wonder why Shaka Smart wouldn't be on their list.
And again, this is just one writer.
I get it.
Just one writer throwing out names.
Yeah.
But I was shocked that Golden was on it. I was shocked that Golden. You were ahead of it. You asked me yesterday if I thought there was any chance he was in play. And I said, no, he's got to do it another time or two. But this writer agrees with you that at least his name is among those being bandied about.
Well, the reason that I think it would make sense for Kentucky, again, it's not the ideal scenario, obviously, but if you're now sort of having to scramble, I think what you've seen is, you know, Todd Golden obviously got San Francisco to the NCAA tournament. That's worth something. And he took a Florida program that was very stagnant, and his first year he loses his best player in Colin Castleton, and they have to sort of limp to a 500 season. But this year, he proved exactly what you have to prove. And he did it in the league Kentucky is in. And he won at Kentucky. He proved that he can identify portal players and get them to play at an incredibly high level. He proved that he can construct a roster that's very difficult to stop in terms of the depth that they had in the front court. I think when you look at Todd Golden, knowing where this sport is going, that it is basically going to be, hey, let's go get the best guys in the portal, and not so much the high school recruiting element. I think he'd do great at Kentucky. I mean, look, obviously, I hope he stays at Florida, but if Kentucky calls, he's gone, and he should be gone. So it's an upside hire. I mean, because of what you're saying, he is very young, he is inexperienced, but I will say, he does have 2 years as a head coach in the SEC at a major program, and he did very well against Kentucky.
Yeah, probably should have swept them.
Yeah.
Probably should have swept
them. So, I mean, I don't think it'll end up being Golden.
Right.
But I'll put it this way. Florida will not be the biggest job of Todd Golden's career. He is going to one day be the coach of Kentucky or Kansas or North Carolina or the Heat or something like that.
It sure feels that way, so we'll track that story. Let's take a break. When we come back, Hayes has some headlines. That's next. Stay with us.
It's the ride home with the Frangie Show.
From the Harrell & Harrell Studio, don't settle for less than you deserve.
Get Florida Gators play-by-play baseball on 1010XL.
The 24th-ranked Gators scuffle with South Carolina in the Swamp. Friday night, Saturday, and Sunday afternoon on 1010 AM.
This is Hayes Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in the most exciting, revolutionary pain management that we've seen in decades. Regenerative medicine. If you were tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics right now. They've got two great locations in the Jacksonville area, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. Call them for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. They have availabilities. You can get in, go see them this week. Again, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. QC Kinetics is leading the field in this work. No downtime, no surgery for that pain in your hips, your shoulders, your knees. This is a solution for you. We're talking natural biologics using your body's own power. Give them a call today, 904-274-5522 in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra Beach. That's QC Kinetics.
At Honda, we appreciate all the comparisons to other vehicles. And no matter how many times they compare their vehicles to a Honda, only a Honda is a Honda. Remember, value, quality, safety. There is no substitute. Visit your local Honda dealer now and experience the difference.
Are you thinking about upgrading your outdoor space with turf? Well, you'll love working with Caleb at Sunshine Turf. Genuine, always on time and trustworthy. Frank Frangie here. Look, we had Sunshine Turf design and install turf at the Bragan Baseball Complex. Man, it's gorgeous and it's maintenance-free. From putting greens to practice areas for kids' sports to pet runs to surrounding your pool, there's endless possibilities at Sunshine. So visit sunshineturf.info or give Caleb a call today at 904-892-0580 for Sunshine Turf.
Ready for a heating and air company that's just as local as your favorite coffee shop? That's Bold City Heating and Air. Jacksonville grown, family owned and operated, and not bought out by the out-of-town big guys. And with transparent pricing, you'll know the costs up front, with options to choose from, backed by Bold City's satisfaction guarantee. And rest assured, Bold City techs will treat your home with white glove service. You can be comfortable today. Visit BoldCityAC.com.
I'm here with Danny Van Sickle, director of the Electrical Training Alliance. Danny, tell me about your program.
Hey, Rick. We're a five-year electrical apprenticeship. Our students start out making over $40,000 a year, and right now graduate making over $90,000 a year, including benefits. There is no tuition or no student debt. You just have to apply and get accepted.
Did you say no tuition and no student debt?
You heard that right, Rick. Once you're accepted to the program, your only costs are the books and the course fees, about $800 a year.
That sounds like an amazing opportunity. How can I learn more?
Just go to etajax.org, and you can apply there.
Apply by May 23rd.
Start your Sunday off with a cup of Joe and some sports medicine intel. This is Joe C. inviting you to join me and Dr. George Barry for Breaking Bones every Sunday morning at 7:30. And if you miss an episode, just look for Breaking Bones wherever you listen to podcasts.
The Jacksonville Icemen are playoff bound. There are three regular season home games left. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena. The Icemen fight for a division title this weekend, starting Friday against the Savannah Ghost Pirates. The first 1,000 fans get a Fang the Mascot bobblehead. Then Saturday at 7 and Sunday at 3, it's the Atlanta Gladiators. Get tickets at Ticketmaster, JacksonvilleIcemen.com, or call 904-602-PUCK. Icemen hockey is hashtag Fire Within.
This is Hayes Carline for First Florida Credit Union. I bank with First Florida Credit Union because I trust them. I can always count on them when it comes to the vast services they provide. First Florida Credit Union was voted Best Bank in the 2023 Best of Bold City Community Choice Awards, and it's easy to see why. I go to the branch off 210 in St. Johns County and the new Durbin location, but they have 10 branches in the Jacksonville area. You need to be banking with First Florida Credit Union. They're enriching people every day. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Opportunity Lender.
Want to play golf and help raise some money for scholarships at the same time? Join the Clay County Gator Club at their 24th annual scholarship golf tournament presented by Walker Footings, Sunday, April 21st. To register, go to claygators.com.
Hey folks, Mike Dempsey here. You've heard me talking about Pella windows and doors, and with great ratings and expert reviews, you know they're high quality and energy efficient products. So what's your next step? How about scheduling a free consultation or just stop by the Pella showroom right there on Phillips Highway next to Tesla? Pella's professional consultants will guide you through your entire project from start to finish. From simple projects to complex renovations, their team has the experience needed to make your project a success. And that's the quality and service you can expect from Pella Windows and Doors.
Daily's Dash is not only your Jaguars game day stop, but a great place to grab a meal any day of the week. To honor the Jags and the fans, we've crafted the Duval Sub. The Duval comes with freshly sliced turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheese, topped with crisp lettuce, fresh tomatoes, and a double portion of our secret sauce, all served on a fresh roll. Come by your local's Daily's Dash today to get your delicious Duval Sub. Daily's is the official convenience store sponsor of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Men, suffering from ED or PE? You'll see instant results on your first visit at Prime Men's Medical Center. For a limited time, your initial consultation and first treatment are totally free. You'll even get a gift that enhances performance in the bedroom. Call 904-664-8217.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Gather around!
It's Hayes's Headlines, presented by Harrell & Harrell. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
Hear all about it.
Here's Hayes Carline.
All right, welcome back to the Frangie Show. Frank Frangie, J.J. LaSelva. I'm Hayes Carline with you. We appreciate our friends at Harrell & Harrell. Give them a call at 251-1111 if, unfortunately, you're dealing with an injury, and hopefully you're not. All right, Frank, let's dive right in. We talked about this to lead off the show. O.J. Simpson dies at 76 from cancer. My question to you is, how would this story play out if it happened today with the social media like we have today? Yeah. Can you imagine if we had had Twitter that afternoon with the Bronco chase?
Well, no, I can't, because that's one of the few stories that had the kind of attention that today's stories get with social media. There was so much attention that it was rare then for something to be so talked about that it dominated every water cooler in every industry in every city in America. So, you know what, Hayes? It wouldn't have been a whole lot different. There'd have been memes and jokes, but it wouldn't have been a whole lot different because that got so much attention. Every other story, you could talk about how heightened the attention would be. That one, how much more could it have gotten?
I do think this. We joke about in society about breaking Twitter or breaking the internet.
Yes.
When that verdict came in.
Oh, I know.
If it happened in 2024, it would have broken the internet.
And we said this at the top of the program. It spawned more notoriety and more people's identities. I mean, Robert Kardashian and Johnny Cochran and Cato Kaelin and Johnny Ito or Judge Ito. And,
yeah.
I mean, there was. And we could go on and on. Marsha Clark. And we could go on and on. People that nobody had ever heard of that now everybody's heard of.
That's right. It was unbelievable. Certainly one of the most bizarre stories, if not the of my lifetime. In terms of the Masters, so Bryson DeChambeau, 7-under, Frank. Give me your call right now on a Thursday afternoon. Is Bryson DeChambeau going to be the 2024 Masters champion?
I'm going to say no. Lee Smith made a good point. He's not the kind of guy likely to choke once he gets there. He's got a mental toughness about him. But somehow I think other players are better players today than him. Will Zalatoris is a really good player. He's only 4 behind. Scottie Scheffler has it to 3. He's still my pick, even 4 behind. There's too many others in the field, so I don't think DeChambeau holds on. But I agree with Lee. I don't think it's because he crumbles. I don't think he spits the bit. I think it's more that other players get close and one of the other players passes it.
In our Loser Monday update, Scottie Scheffler's wife has not gone into labor yet. So JJ LaSalva sitting pretty with Scottie Scheffler 3-under par as we just kind of are getting going here. So it's hard to get a feel, but the big what we're waiting on is for Meredith Scheffler. How does she feel is what I'm worried about. That's what we need to know.
Wouldn't that be tremendous if JJ's first
maiden voyage,
first entry point into Loser Monday. He's about to win easily.
Sounds
and
terrible.
And the guy DQs with 2 to play.
Can you imagine the gift basket we will send her?
Let me just tell you what. If that happens, I will drive behind him just to watch him walk into the Bonos. We're not, JJ, you knew this. We're not nice people here.
If it's like today, I sort of could get it that he would go because it's a Thursday. You don't necessarily know you're going to be there on a Sunday. But if it's like Saturday night, he's in the final pairing or only like 2 shots back or something. She can't do that to him.
He's so crazy. And as we're saying that, by the way, Cam Smith just hit one right in the water.
Oh, yeah. No. Okay.
As we're saying that. So Scottie Scheffler can do whatever he wants.
He's up to 4.
Wow. If I can get Cam to miss a cut here, we should be okay. Oh.
Yeah, how about that? All right, moving on to college football. The orange and blue game is Saturday. We have the rosters. The blue team features Graham Mertz, Wilson, Montrell Johnson, DK. So Graham Mertz getting certainly his guys. It looks like the orange team has more, I'd say, of the frontline defensive players. It will also have freshman sensation DJ Lagway.
You know, I know you're going to the game. I haven't decided, but we'll be tomorrow live at Spurrier's.
Yeah.
And we'll have some of the, I think Shane Matthews is coming by. Freddie Wiebe, who runs the Victorious, is going to stop by and tell us all about what NIL really is. So we got a lot of fun stuff. Can't wait to go to Spurrier's, where the great restaurants around in that area. The ball coach may or may not come by. That'd be kind of fun. So looking forward to that. I know you're going to the game. It's a very important spring for Florida. It's a very important spring for Billy Napier's career, and it's going to be a fun weekend for sure.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And if you're a Gators fan that has not been to Spurrier's, definitely put that at the top of your list. It is fantastic in terms of all the memorabilia that they have at that restaurant. All right, the Cleveland Browns have reworked running back Nick Chubb's deal to save $9 million. Chubb suffered a gruesome knee injury in week 2, but it's good that he is staying with the club.
Yeah, I think he's a really good player. In fact, you could have made the argument that he was in the conversation in these recent years with Christian McCaffrey and Derrick Henry and Jonathan Taylor to be among the best running backs in the league. He might be the 4th or 5th. You know, there's 4 or 5 guys you could have that conversation. Saquon Barkley not that long ago. I think Nick Chubb pre-injury, Hayes, was that good. Whether he'll be that good post-injury, we'll see.
Yeah, absolutely. The Chiefs receiver, Rashee Rice, who had that sensational rookie year, faces 8 charges, including aggravated assault after the high-speed crash, punishable up to 20 years in prison. Rice had 1,200 yards receiving and 8 touchdowns if you count the playoffs last year for the Chiefs.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to be in jail for 20 years, but there's a side of me that would be surprised if he plays in the NFL anytime soon.
Yeah, I agree. We talked about the Kentucky job. I'm shocked Scott Drew turned it down. If it isn't Billy D, Frank, I thought it'd be Nate Oates. You thought it'd be Scott Drew. Who is it?
Well, I'll say this. And what's happening in sports all around, guys with really good jobs are not taking great jobs. Guys with medium jobs are taking good jobs. But guys with really good jobs, and Baylor's a great job, guys with really good jobs aren't jumping to the great job. Have you noticed that?
Yeah.
In all the sports, they're not jumping quite as quickly. So I don't, to your question, I wouldn't be surprised if they circle back to one of the names you heard was out, whether it's Nate Oates or Donovan. I don't think it's Jay Wright. I don't think it's Danny Hurley. It's obviously now not Drew, but it would not surprise me if one of those other names resurfaced. It really would.
The gentleman who is leaving Lexington, John Calipari, the new Arkansas coach, had one of the greatest sound bites that I've heard in recent times. JJ, please play that for us.
You know what? I'm jacked about another opportunity. Like, I'm like, let's go. Now, I met with the team. There is no team. So now I got to – Hunter's really extremely confident, but we got to get a roster together. And some of it is a little bit of everything, but we will. It may take a little longer.
It's
I met with the team.
Yeah, and it's going to take a little longer because they're waiting on the NBA deadline and guys that are going to pull their name out of the draft. So that was sort of what he was cautioning to finish his thought there. But, Frank, tell me if am I crazy? Now that John Calipari is out of Kentucky and he's coaching Arkansas, I kind of like him.
Yeah. Listen, I've never hated Cal. He's a little pompous, but I don't mind a little pomposity in my coach, you know? He's always been kind of funny. So I'm with you. No, I never hated – I never could root for Kentucky because they were such a Goliath. But I never minded Cal. So, no, I get it, and I'm kind of with you on that.
Giannis has a calf strain, is going to be out until the playoffs start. It's sort of undetermined right now. The Bucks are currently the 2 seed in the East. Are you worried about Milwaukee?
I am not. I don't follow it very closely. JJ, jump in here. Are the Celtics as unbeatable in the East as it would appear?
No. I think when the playoffs gets here, I mean, they lost to Miami last year.
Yeah.
So, no, I think it would have been huge if Giannis went down. If you remember last year, Miami beat them. They were in the number one seed because Giannis didn't even play. Like, he wasn't healthy the whole series. So, this is terrible timing for an injury. I hope that even when he does come back in the playoffs that he's, you know, 100% because this kind of sucks. But, no, I don't think the Celtics are unbeatable. Absolutely not.
Yeah, and they've got a history, recent history of to your point, kind of choking that they're going to have to get beyond. All right, moving to Major League Baseball and the Shohei Ohtani scandal. The feds are accusing the interpreter of a $16 million heist, so they're accusing him of bank fraud. Faces up to 30 years in prison.
Yeah, and you and I disagreed on this. I kind of think he did it. I know a lot of people think he's covering for Shohei. And if Shohei wasn't innocent, I think he kind of was. I think Shohei just was asleep at the wheel on this one. These interpreters don't just interpret. They handle your bank accounts. They handle your business affairs. I hope the guy goes to jail for a long time.
In light of the Masters starting today, I wanted to take us back to one of my favorite Masters moments. This comes from the 2004 edition.
Is it his time? And it's hard to believe there's a more popular winner in any single one year than Phil Mickelson in 2004.
Hard to believe it's been 20 years since that happened.
How about that?
Yeah.
20 years.
20 years. But Phil Mickelson wins his first major, conquering Augusta National, beating Ernie Els by one stroke.
Amazing stuff. The Masters never fails to deliver. Really does. Right? That is Hayes Headlines. We've got an hour to go. We'll have it for you after this.
The Frangie Show from the Harrell and Harrell Studio. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
Now,
a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. A little magic from world number one Scotty Scheffler from the greenside bunker at Golden Bell, the par 3, hole number 12.
Blade wide open, big swing, flops it onto the green, up toward the hole, has a chance, and it goes! Slams into the flag with some pace, and just like that, Scotty Scheffler makes a birdie. Three birdies, no bogeys today.
John McGinnis, the call on SiriusXM. Scheffler, 3-under and 4-off Bryson DeChambeau's lead. DeChambeau's in the clubhouse with a 7-under 65. Rory McIlroy's in the same group as Scheffler. He birdied 12 to move back to red numbers. McIlroy is 1-under par. He is 6-back. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
The less your business spends, the more margin you keep. But today, everything costs more. So smart businesses are graduating to NetSuite by Oracle. NetSuite is the number one cloud financial system, bringing accounting, financial management, inventory, HR into one proven platform, helping you reduce IT costs, maintenance costs, and manual errors. Over 37,000 companies have already made the move to NetSuite. Now through April 15th, NetSuite is offering a one-of-a-kind flexible financing program. Head to netsuite.com/golf right now. netsuite.com/golf.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
The last groups have teed off here in the first round at the Masters. They have to deal with gusts greater than 30 miles an hour. Thunderstorms pushed through this morning, delaying the start by 2.5 hours. Let's check the leaderboard, sponsored by NetSuite. Head to netsuite.com/golf now through April 15th for a one-of-a-kind flexible financing program. Bryson DeChambeau navigated that wind pretty well. 7-under 65. He's got a 3-shot lead at the moment. DeChambeau started with 3 consecutive birdies. Then, in a 6-hole stretch on the second nine, he put up 5 birdies at 12, 13, 15, 16, and 17 before closing with a par at 18. At 4-under, 3-back, it's Danny Willett, former Masters champion, and Matt Fitzpatrick, who is through 13 holes. Ryan Fox, Ben On, Will Zalatoris, Scotty Scheffler, Wyndham Clark, and Cameron Davis all at 3-under. Tiger Woods opening with a birdie, then a nice par save at 2. He had to hit his second from the pine straw left-handed when the ball nestled right next to a tree. Tiger with a par there and a par at 3. He's 1-under, 6-back. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
I'm Holt Harrell with Harrell & Harrell. Choosing a law firm after an accident is an important decision. So how do you decide? With so many messages on air, I know it can all sound the same. At Harrell & Harrell, we believe what sets us apart is our commitment to you. When you've been injured in an accident, you need help from someone you know, someone you can trust. Harrell & Harrell, a name you know, a name you trust. Don't settle for less than you deserve. Offices, Jacksonville.
Is your AC system showing signs of wear and tear? Get ahead of your AC system replacement before the summer with JTM Comfort Services. Nothing worse than coming home on a hot summer afternoon to find your AC stopped working. Right now, get a special rebate on the purchase and installation of an 18 to 20 SEER Bosch heat pump system. Financing now available on qualified repairs and replacements.
Your comfort is our name. Call my dad to keep you in the game.
Folks, you tired of shopping those online dealers that overpromise and underdeliver? Are you ready to sell or looking for a deal? Well, you can find your next used vehicle at Nimnik Buick GMC with Car Bravo, a better way to shop used vehicles online with transparent pricing. With Car Bravo, Nimnik Buick GMC certifies all makes and models: Honda, Toyota, Kia, Mazda, Ford, all makes, all models. And buying a certified used vehicle has never felt better. Nimnik Buick GMC is proud to be named the number one Car Bravo dealer in the Southeast region and top 10 in the country. That's one more reason to head to Nimnik for all your automotive needs. They got a great selection, hundreds of used cars, trucks, and SUVs to choose from. So head to Nimnik today and buy a car with Car Bravo. That's Nimnik Buick GMC. Nimnik, your friends in the car business since 1941.
WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
A lot of companies will tell you they're the best. At Custom Tree Surgeons, they show you every time. Custom Tree Surgeons has built an all-pro team. Every tree service professional has years of experience, continually trained and certified. They know what, when, and how to handle any job. It gets done efficiently and quickly by a team of experts. So for tree trimming, removal, stump grinding, and emergency services, forget any name other than Custom Tree Surgeons. There is no job they can't do better. Go to website, CustomTreeSurgeons.com. That's CustomTreeSurgeons.com. And let them show you how the job is supposed to get done.
If you've played sports or still lead an active life, chances are joint pain is nothing new. This is Dr. George Bari of Bari Orthopedics, and we like to be your option when it comes to taking care of your body and getting back in the game. From shoulders to elbows to hip and knee pain, Bari Orthopedics can diagnose and treat a variety of injuries that are causing you pain. We are Bari Orthopedics and online at BariOrthopedics.com. With more than 30 years of experience, our team is here to care for your entire family.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I Orthopedics.com.
It's Kubota Orange Days, your golden chance to score a deal that will make your neighbors green with envy. Shop the year's best selection of Kubota tractors, zero-turn mowers, and utility vehicles, including the number one selling compact tractor in the USA. And get the year's best deals, like 0% APR for 84 months or up to $3,300 off L3302 tractors. Coastal Equipment on New Kings Road and in McClenny. Coastal Equipment.
E.T. here, and it's time for the Taste of Golf at TPC Sawgrass, April 24th. Join me for fine cuisine from chefs from the top golf clubs in our area, craft cocktails, games, and unique auction items. This is one of the most charitable events in our area. Come network with a sophisticated audience who is passionate about golf and its values, all while impacting the youth in our community. All proceeds benefit First Tee North Florida. For tickets, go to tasteofgolf.com. Come on, somebody.
At Charmin, we heard you shouldn't talk about going to the bathroom in public, so we decided to sing about it.
When you roll the Charmin Ultra Soft on the potty, this is more, so roll it back, everybody. Charmin's irresistibly soft and hella nice. The crib is always stocked. It's our potty vibe. She's crushing everything, so my cheeks feel fine. So worth it. Everybody wanna touch the sky.
Charmin Ultra Soft is irresistibly soft and more absorbent, so you can use less. Enjoy the go with Charmin.
This is your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. I'm Andrew Gibson for 1010XL. This update brought to you by Southern Oak Insurance. After signing a five-year extension on Wednesday, Jaguars linebacker Josh Allen delivered a message for Jacksonville.
Duval, we back. I'm excited. You know I am. This is home, man. Forever. It started my NFL career. Hopefully I can end my NFL career as a, you know, as a Duval thoroughbred. You know, I wouldn't want to be nowhere else. This is why I extended my legacy, and this is why I want to end my legacy. I want to one day look back and be known as one of the best Jacksonville football players ever.
Josh Allen, courtesy of Jaguars.com. It's 79 degrees at 5:13. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Frank Frangie, Hayes Car Line, J.J. LaSelva on a Stanley Pools Thursday. Glad you're with us on the program today. The updates of the day, you probably know by now if you've been listening to our updates. Bryson DeChambeau, the story today. He shot 65. He's at 7-under and in the clubhouse. Scottie Scheffler still on the golf course, is at 4-under. Danny Willett is on the golf course also. No, correction, he shot 68. He's at 4-under. Will Zalatoris still on the golf course at 4-under as well.
Some How of the about big Scheffler? He's just a machine.
And that's why I asked Lee, if he wins the Masters.
So that would be two Masters in 3 years.
Right, and back-to-back.
With back-to-back players.
And back-to-back players. I've got to believe this is as hot as anyone. It's nothing like what Tiger did, But it's as hot as anybody since then, hasn't it?
Well, and if he wins this, he will have won the Players and the Masters, and then it makes you wonder, what's he going to do in the PGA US Open and British?
Pretty amazing stuff. Meanwhile, Tiger on the course.
By the way, Tiger looks like he could bench press 450 pounds right now.
One thing he didn't do is leave the gym.
No.
Of all the things the injury kept him from doing, it wasn't working out, wasn't a problem. He is at even. He's on the fifth hole. He is at even par. He birdied number one. He's made a bogey somewhere along the line. I don't know where. And he's on number five now. So, again,
He bogeyed four.
He bogeyed four. Okay. He looks good hitting the golf ball. He just the big question with Tiger is, can he continue to walk up and down the undulation that Lee Smith was talking about as well today?
I mean, I'm not sure Dallas Turner and Jared Verse have physiques like this.
you're right about that. I mean, he really is. So, you're exactly right. Tiger Woods, and so we'll continue to keep you up to date on that. The other news we've told you about a little bit today, Scott Drew is not going to take the Kentucky job. All right, so who are you handicapping now, Carlisle?
It's tough. If all the guys, if they all stay out, again, I thought it would be Nate Oates. I was dead wrong. I thought Scott Drew made a lot of sense. I'm really surprised he's not leaving Baylor for that job. I still don't think it's Billy D. I just don't think that the college realm is where he wants to go until he's forced to go there. And it doesn't seem like he's in great danger of losing his job. I mean, JJ, if the Bulls, they're going to make the playoffs, right?
Pretty
much.
Yeah,
like,
they're like a 500 team.
Yeah, so if they're –
that's good enough in the East.
Let's say they're just an early out in the playoffs. Is he fired, do you think?
No way.
Yeah,
no.
So, I mean, if I just don't think Billy Donovan's going to go unless he just has no real choice, and obviously he does here. So the other thing, too, is, like, it'd be all – you know, glorious for Billy Donovan at Kentucky for a month, but let him go 17-15 in his first year there, and all he's going to hear when he leaves his house
is
the game has passed him by.
That's
You know, he's completely out of touch with how college basketball works.
Correct. And, I mean, anybody that goes 17-15 in Kentucky is going to hear the noise, but that would be the noise he would hear. That's the specifics of it.
And he hasn't been paying any attention to And the portal and
I do get the sense if it was good and I'm not convinced Billy Donovan's not the guy, but I do get the sense that if it was going to be him, there would be some smoke now, wouldn't there?
You would think.
Just some smoke.
Plus, is Billy Donovan going to leave to be the fourth choice somewhere?
Yeah.
Because that's how it's going to be. Yeah, it's going to be hard for Kentucky to spend whoever they end up hiring that this was our guy all along. So I think Shaka Smart would make a lot of sense.
You don't hear him at all.
You don't, but I mean, he's done a good job at Marquette, and he's still relatively young. You know, obviously, 15 years ago he got VCU to a Final Four. You know, so
it might just be the next young guy. If it's not Nate Oates, it might be Brad Underwood from Illinois, who's a good coach. It might be the
and they were a 3 seed, yeah.
Yeah, it might be the Iowa State guy. They were a 2 seed, so it might be. It just might be the next year. We and at least I am guilty of thinking Kentucky's too good for the next guy in line, the next guy in the hopper. It's got to be a bigger name. It's got to be Donovan or Drew or one of these guys that have a title. But it might not be Hayes. It might just be the next guy in the hopper, which would make it Brad Underwood or the Iowa State guy or whoever.
Let me ask you this. Would you call Tom Izzo?
No, I don't think it's a guy that age.
He's 69.
Yeah, I don't think it's that. I don't think Billy at 59 is too old. He's a young 59, but I would think that's about. I wouldn't call Bruce Pearl, who's 63 or 64. I don't think it's that. I think it's a young coach, or youngish coach, which is why Drew's not super young. He's been 21 years at Baylor, but I think it's youngish. Don't you sense? What do you think? Same question.
I probably would not, but I will say that, I mean, I probably wouldn't, but if Tom Izzo wanted to coach, if he feels like he's going to coach another 5 or 6 years, I mean, I think obviously he'd do a great job at Kentucky. And again, he is comfortable in the space of what being a college basketball coach is all about these days. He's navigated the waters. So you know, even though he's older, if he was committed to, you know, hey, I really want to do this for 5 years, I'd consider it. again, at this point. I mean, if I was Mitch Barnhart, I would have given Nate Oates $12 million a year. I mean, assuming that's in his budget, and I have to think it is. I mean, I just would have given Nate Oates a deal that basically he couldn't refuse.
You really liked him as the choice, didn't you?
I think he'd been.
I mean, from day one, that was your guy.
I think Nate Oates at Kentucky would be Patino good.
Yeah, yeah, I hear you. And it's interesting, so many of the pundits, so many of the stories you read suggest that the reason he's not in play is the $18 million buyout. That doesn't seem like it would dissuade.
Yeah.
I mean, this is Kentucky
basketball.
You're paying
Mark Stoops $9 million to coach your football team.
Yeah, I wouldn't think.
That you barely care about.
Yeah, right. I wouldn't think Kentucky basketball would be dissuaded if they really wanted the guy for $18 million. Would you? I mean,
I would not.
I think that's the thing that surprises me.
I mean, call Josh Allen. He's an alum. He just got a bunch of money.
By the way, other stories we've seen, we track. Did you see the Tom Brady story?
I did not.
I'll give you credit. JJ, you probably don't know this. You weren't producing our show in the past, but Hayes Carline has insisted Tom Brady's not done playing football, and he's been insisting it since he retired.
I thought he was going to come back last year.
Yeah, last
year.
I never thought he was coming back, but apparently on an appearance on the quote unquote Deep Cut podcast released today, Brady was asked by host Vic Blends if he would pick up the phone if a team called him in the event of an injury. Brady, quote, "I'm not opposed to it. I don't know if they're going to let me if I become an owner of an NFL team. But I'm always going to be in good shape. I'll always be able to throw the ball. So to come for a little bit," that's great. You know you're good when you talk about playing quarterback in the NFL is a little bit.
Right.
"But to come for a little bit, like MJ coming back, I don't know if they would let me, but I wouldn't be opposed to it." This is Brady pretty much saying, listen, if you're having a good year and your quarterback blows a knee with 5 weeks to play, give me a jingle.
That'd be amazing.
You know what he's saying?
Yeah, I mean, I'm just reading it now, and it's, I would agree in that I think he could still be effective even past Thanksgiving of this calendar year. I don't think it's going to happen because of the unless it's for the Raiders, but I obviously is Tom's alluding to the ownership becoming a minority owner of the Las Vegas Raiders would certainly complicate that. But can he still play? I absolutely think Tom
Brady
can
still play.
He's
like a boxer.
Yeah.
He just can't give it up, man.
Yeah, I mean so that.
Well, I mean I think he did because I think he could have played at a high level last year.
Yeah.
And he walked away.
I agree.
Yeah. I what happens, though, and I've seen this 1,000 times with coaches more than players, once you're not the king anymore, the longer you're not the king, the harder it is to not be the king.
Yeah.
Which is why coaches come out of retirement. Well, if you're good enough as a player to do it and go be the king again for a few weeks, you probably do it.
Yeah.
I've never believed he was coming back, but I understand that.
And obviously he says, I'll always be able to throw the ball. Well, I don't agree with that. I mean, that will eventually expire, but sure. I mean, look, if Trevor Lawrence, God forbid, got a season-ending injury at some point this season, I would have zero problem. I'd much rather have Tom Brady than Mac Jones.
Both Patriot legends.
Yes.
We'll take a break.
And we'll sign Garoppolo, too, just to get the band back together.
We'll take a break. I want to make a quick point about the stadium deal that's out there. We haven't talked about that in a bit. By the way, my buddy John Dever, speaking of the Jags, just made a great point. From June of 17 to May of 19, Koepka won four majors. That was pretty hot, too. In hottest since Tiger.
And he's the reigning PGA.
Yeah.
In terms of that run, it was
two U.S.
Hot.
Open, the two PGAs. He could not win, it seemed like. John, thanks for that. Very good point. Let's take a break. I wanted to make a point I've made before, but I'm going to make it again about a stadium deal in Jacksonville. That's next. Stay with us.
The Frangie Show from the Harrell & Harrell Studio. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
Now, a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emrick. 1 year ago, Will Zalatoris had to withdraw from the Masters the morning of the first round because of injury. Not long after, he underwent back surgery and missed the rest of the season. Zalatoris is back, now using a broomstick putter, and it's been a godsend for three-foot putts like he had at 15.
This is the range that he struggles from. He's got a long putter now. Not anchored, but up near his chest, left edge, and it curls in. That putter has been the answer for Will Zalatoris in this comeback from back surgery. Birdie here at 15, and Zalatoris is now 4 under.
Brian Katrick, the call on SiriusXM. Zalatoris has been a runner-up at three different majors in his career, including here in 2021. Just got to be careful anytime a patron gives him a hug. The back is holding up so far. Zalatoris tied for second with Danny Willett and Scottie Scheffler. They're 4 under, 3 back of Bryson DeChambeau, who is 7 under and in the clubhouse. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
Todd is a real Prevagen user, and this is his story.
Hi, I'm Todd, and I live in Georgia. I'm a veteran of 23 years. I love to give back to the community, whether it's my fellow veterans, some guy on the street corner. I offer what I can, when I can. I started noticing that my memory was slipping, and I wanted to take proactive measures to try to help that. I saw a Prevagen commercial, and I did some research on it, and I wanted to find out, does this stuff really work? I started taking Prevagen about 3 years ago. Since taking Prevagen, I feel clearer in my thoughts, my memory has improved, and generally just more on point.
Prevagen is available in stores everywhere without a prescription. Based on a clinical study of subgroups of individuals who are cognitively normal or mildly impaired, this product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Testimonialist was compensated for their time.
Bryson DeChambeau posting the score to beat as we wind through the first round at the Masters. Let's check the leaderboard, sponsored by Prevagen. Prevagen is the most recommended memory support brand by pharmacists. DeChambeau, a 7-under 65, 8 birdies, 1 bogey today for the 2020 U.S. Open champion. DeChambeau with a 3-shot advantage over Danny Willett, 2016 Masters champ, Will Zalatoris, and Scottie Scheffler, the 2022 Masters champion. Zalatoris now through 16 holes after a par there. Scheffler is through 14. At 3-under par, Ryan Fox, Matt Fitzpatrick, and Matthew Pavon from France. Pavon, one of the last few players to tee off. He's through 6 holes. Tiger Woods even through 4 after a bogey at number 4. He opened with a birdie. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emrick. Westwood One Sports.
There are trucks, and then there's the truck, the GMC Sierra. Frank Frangie here, with available features like the V8 engine, the ultimate luxury interior, and of course, the available world's first 6-function multi-pro tailgate. Nemec Buick GMC has the largest inventory of GMC Sierras in the area. This month, save up to $10,000 off new GMC Sierra 1500 or enjoy rates as low as 1.9% APR financing. You get it at Nemec GMC. We are professional grade.
I'm Holt Harrell. I was talking to someone the other day, and they were shocked that some lawyers get more from a case than their own client. After paying bills and costs, if we are supposed to get more than a client, we won't. That's the Harrell and Harrell promise. When we say that we treat our clients like family, we mean it. If you've been in an accident, call us today. 251-1111. Harrell and Harrell. Offices, Jacksonville.
Hi, folks. I'm Frank Frangie for Ricketts Electric. Now, any good lineup needs power. When I needed a power connection for our new walk-off charities baseball park, I found the perfect partner in Ricketts Electric. You're going to love these guys, I'm telling you. The Ricketts family has been providing commercial and residential electric service for years. So call my buddy Zach Ricketts today at 904-320-5960, and you can find them on Facebook as well. You will trust them. That's Ricketts Electric, the city's best power connection. Call them today at 320-5960.
Does the building you go to work in every day need a little love and attention? Jason Parker here with Performance Painting. Great companies take great care of the buildings their staff and customers walk into every day. If the building you're in doesn't match the vision you have for your company, we can help. Go to performance-painting.com. Our highly trained team makes the difference. Quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting! Frank Frangie here. These days, it's hard to know which companies to trust. But when it comes to banking, I trust South State Bank. South State truly values its customers, and they work hard to create meaningful, lasting relationships. I love going into my local branch. I see the same smiling faces I've seen for years. South State is the largest bank headquartered in Florida, so they're able to offer all the banking services you need. You can trust South State Bank. Banking forward. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Start your Sunday off with a cup of Joe and some sports medicine intel. This is Joe C. inviting you to join me and Dr. George Barry for Breaking Bones every Sunday morning at 7:30. And if you miss an episode, just look for Breaking Bones wherever you listen to podcasts.
Bring your guns and bring your hoses, and we're ready to put up some punches. It's Guns and Hoses Charity Boxing. It's back. It's that time. Bell time. In fact, 6:30, Saturday, April 20th. Join us at UNF Arena. Dan and I there for the millionth year in a row. It is so much fun, this charity boxing, and it's serious, and it's fun, and it's impactful, and you're going to have a great time. By the way, street party before and after the event. Make it a day. Saturday, April 20th. Bell time, 6:30, UNF Arena.
Guns and Hoses.
Need protection? Call Craig and Christine Kaprosky at Goosehead Insurance. The Kaproskys are a husband and wife team committed to finding you the right coverage at the right price in just a few short minutes. For home, auto, flood, or specialty insurance, Craig and Christine Kaprosky are the answer. Craig.Kaprosky at Goosehead.com.
If you're heading to the Aug or you're already part of the nation's oldest, don't forget to drop into Sunset Grill. For over 30 years, serving up great chowder, seafood, wings, and cold beer. Sunset Grill, somewhere on A1A, St. Augustine Beach.
Your cooling system isn't working. Maybe somebody showed up with a portable electronic device. Then they discussed with you what your options are. Maybe they gave you an estimate that seems like an awful lot of money. What's the smart thing to do? When the situation merits a second opinion, get a Mike Merritt opinion. Yes, the Mike Merritt Comfort Team shows up with hand tools. We've never been able to fix an air conditioning problem with a tablet. Mike Merritt has been the trusted name for more than 30 years because there's never any hocus pocus. The Merritt team will walk you through the diagnostic steps up close and personal and show you exactly what you need. And the Mike Merritt price is likely to be far less because there's never an overtime charge, and the Merritt team doesn't work on commission. So remember, when it comes to the health of your cooling system, a second opinion can only help, and a Mike Merritt opinion can save you money. Florida license CACO 50384.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
This is Hayes Carline for Skylife Elite. Are you tired of canceled flights, unruly passengers, and layovers? Call my friends at Skylife Elite. Consider using private charter flights for your next adventure. Yes, you can afford it. Make your own schedule. Fly direct. Drive your car to Craig Airport and get directly on the plane. Skylife Elite can make that happen. Call 490-9332, go to flyskylife.com, and find them on social media. Fly Skylife Elite, North Florida's premier private air charter.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
I'm mad at my wife.
Really? What happened?
Well, we're talking last night. A commercial came on, kind of a silly commercial that reminded us of TV in the 70s. And she had the audacity to say, I can't believe a human would say this, much less a good American. She had the audacity to say that she watched the Brady Bunch in reruns because she's 11 years younger than me. And she thought it was bad acting.
Really?
What is the matter with you?
Bad acting?
I mean, you don't think Marsha Brady was bringing it?
Yeah. I mean, I thought Alice was the Meryl Streep of her time.
JJ, have you ever watched one episode of the Brady Bunch?
Oh, yeah, many.
You have?
Nick at Night, of course.
Okay.
But I was a kid, so I wasn't really judging the acting at that moment.
Yeah.
But
I mean, it started, like 69
that's
probably?
That's what I would guess.
when I was 11, they were bringing that. The fact that Florence Henderson didn't win the Emmy for Best Actress every year.
Every year.
Still astounds me.
It's a shame.
I mean, how could you say that? I mean, let me tell you what. If you're 11 years old and you got the Brady Bunch followed by the Partridge Family, and your mom and dad let you stay up, when,
right?
Okay, I don't know what you had when you were 10 or 11. When you're growing up in San Souci, and you're getting getting Marsha Brady and Lori Partridge back to back. When?
Where did Batman the TV show fall into that? When did they show?
Speaking of great acting,
Well, that's what.
And by the way, you can have Michael Keaton and all the rest of them.
Yeah.
The greatest Batman.
Adam West.
There's no question.
I always felt like Mr. Ed, the acting was lacking in that one.
That one I didn't watch.
I tell you what had great acting was The Munsters.
Yeah. Oh, yes. I loved that show.
It did.
Fantastic acting.
I liked her too. I liked all of them. Listen, I was 10. When you're 10, the girls on TV.
I Dream of Jeannie.
Oh, stop it. Yeah. Don't even get me started.
That's checkmate right there.
My wife thought the Brady Bunch, how can you possibly think? The Greg Brady wasn't bringing it every show.
Yeah,
with the artificial turf lawn. Anyway, I don't know why I thought that, but she said we had this long. I'm not making this up. We had this long discussion last night about it. I said, "Are you really an American? You thought that?" So anyway, so there's that. I want to make a serious point. The Kansas City people, in trying to get a new stadium. By now, everybody knows they did a referendum and asked people to vote, and it got voted down, even though they're the Kansas City Chiefs. And then there's been some chatter that Jacksonville should do a public referendum. I've said this 1,000 times. You've said it. You and I think agree on this one.
Yes.
So let me say it one more time. There's nothing you could do dumber than letting the public vote on whether or not to do a new stadium. There's no dumber decision that you could make.
Yeah, just let them just say we're going to let them go.
Because a referendum to spend tax dollars on an entertainment facility will never pass, no matter what the entertainment enterprise is. It will never pass. A symphony hall, a concert hall, a new theater will never pass if taxpayer dollars have to go into it. Not ever, because there's too many people that don't agree with the cause or aren't interested in the cause. If you, as a taxpayer, if you asked me, and there was a referendum out there, to vote on a new symphony hall, I would vote no, because I don't give a damn about the symphony. But I would rather not be asked, because I'm smart enough to know that I don't have enough knowledge to vote intelligently, which is why I have elected leaders who I have elected and who I trust to get the vote right. And that's what the mayor and the city council does. So I cannot say this clear enough. I'm not intelligent enough or well-read enough to make intelligent votes on whether or not the city should spend significant dollars on an entertainment venue of this significance. Therefore, I'm not convinced, or similarly, I'm not convinced that other citizens are either. That is why you have elected officials who you trust to know more about the symphony hall or the stadium. I bring it up, Hayes, because I see chatter everywhere now on social media. Should be a referendum, because we're getting close. Well, A, there's not going to be a referendum, thankfully. And number two, that makes no sense at all. It's one of the dumbest things I've seen in a long time.
Yeah, it's well said. And again, I'm not an symphony enthusiast either. But I like the fact that I live in a city that having the symphony hall enriches the experience of living in the city. Because while I don't particularly go, at least not yet in my life, I appreciate the fact that there's people that love it. And it enhances the city to have it. But I've made this point several times, and it's the only way that I know how to make it. If you could take the Louvre in Paris, which is arguably the greatest art museum on this planet, it's where the Mona Lisa is. and many other priceless works of art. If you could somehow put that museum here in Jacksonville and all you needed was to vote on it, it would not pass.
Correct.
If the federal government said, we want to expand the Smithsonian, we want to have this expansion of the Smithsonian in Jacksonville, we want to be one of the cities, we're going to have this massive, great museum, but it's going to be put to a public vote, it would not pass, because there is nothing in the world of entertainment that anyone will ever, the masses will ever agree on 51%. It just doesn't exist.
So to that end, Hayes, anybody suggesting we should do a referendum, and if it's an intelligent person saying it, they're hoping it doesn't pass.
There's no doubt. You're sabotaging the city to suggest it.
Correct.
Sabotaging the city to suggest it.
Anybody that suggests there should be a referendum is hoping there's not a new stadium and really hoping that the team leaves.
Absolutely.
If you want a referendum, then for all practical purposes, you are kind of saying you hope the Jags don't play here in the future.
But
you
I don't really want it blamed on me.
Yeah, right. Yeah, baby. So if you're someone that ever really wanted to see a referendum of the vote, then you're kind of saying you hope the team isn't here because you know it won't pass. Everybody knows. Now, by the way, it cannot pass and still get done. The Kansas City Chiefs are still going to do the Chiefs aren't news bulletin. The Chiefs aren't leaving, even though it failed. I don't know what the next step is, but it's not that it's not. And by the way, I don't think the Hunt family is going to build it themselves. So ultimately, Kansas City will contribute and participate in the building of the stadium. It's just an interesting thing. And I saw it on social, and I had to get that out. We'll take a break. One segment to go. We'll wrap the program after this. Stay with us.
It's the ride home with the Frangie Show from the Harrell & Harrell Studio. Don't settle for less than you deserve.
This is Brent Musburger's Action Update, brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, here are the latest lines from my guys in the desert.
NBA, the Boston Celtics are the favorite to win this year's NBA title, plus 165. Celtics with the best record in the league, with the regular season wrapping up this weekend. The Denver Nuggets are plus 300 to repeat as NBA champions. Los Angeles Clippers plus 900. The Oklahoma City Thunder plus 1600. Masters got off to a late start due to weather at Augusta National. Scottie Scheffler is the betting favorite to capture his second career green jacket. Download VSiN's free 30-page Masters betting primer at VSIN.com. This update brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning, a proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. I'm Tony Desiri with your VSiN Action Update on 1010XL.
Duck Duck Rooter is a full-service plumbing company that's locally owned and operated, fully licensed and insured. We'll be at your home in a timely manner, provide honest pricing, and ensure the job is completed correctly, or we'll make it right. Duck Duck Rooter can handle all plumbing jobs, including repairing broken pipes, clearing clogged drains, to installing new fixtures, water heaters, garbage disposals, and full repipes for older homes. If you're stuck, call the Duck, 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
When you're a little kid on the playground, they tell you, don't hit back. Well, the courtroom isn't a playground. And if you've suffered an injury or death in your family, I'm here to tell you it's okay to hit back and fight to make them pay. I'm attorney Brett Hastings, and at Hastings Injury Law, we understand all the pain and emotion that comes with being wrong. And we've dedicated our lives to making things right for people like you. So if you get hit, hit back with Hastings Injury Law. Offices, Jacksonville.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Prosser here, and Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make that happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off
all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally, hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508. That's loanpronto.com at 904-999-1508. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
He's a professor of quarterback play and class is in session.
We want to take you into the lab so you can learn more about the science of quarterback.
Denny Thompson, Friday mornings on The Drill, brought to you by Tyson Sound and Security and George Moore Chevrolet on 1010XL.
When my wrist pain was acting up and I needed help, I took Dan Hicken's advice and headed over to see the experts at Southeast Orthopedic Specialists. This is Stuart Moore with the PGA Tour. I highly recommend Southeast Orthopedic Specialists. Whenever you have a need, they took great care of me. They'll take great care of you.
This is Dr. Kevin Murphy. The next time you need orthopedic care, you can rely on our team at Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
All right, guys, be a true grill master with the Sausage Dudes Sausage and upgrade that cookout. The Sausage Dudes are guys from Jacksonville who use their family recipes to make better sausage with the best cuts of pork, carefully sourced spices, and natural casings. And the Sausage Dudes are mission-minded, supporting the Boys and Girls Club of Northeast Florida. Try all four flavors because your cookout deserves better. Now available at all Publix stores in the frozen meat section. Head to Publix today and get your hands on the Sausage Dudes Sausage.
There are three certainties in life: death, taxes, and if you stay in your home long enough, a new roof. Pick it here for our friends at Lockhart Roofing. Nobody better in Jacksonville. How do I know? They are a local certified Master Elite contractor, and that means they have a GAF Master Elite warranty. That's the best in the roofing industry. In this day and age, don't settle for cheaper discount roofers. Lockhart Roofing has been here for decades. They aren't going anywhere. Call my friends at Lockhart Roofing, 994-3851. That's 994-3851. Lockhart Roofing, Jacksonville's best for Jacksonville people.
Jacksonville, the ultimate rock experience, Big Engine, is storming into Players Grill Mandarin, known for electric performances at NASCAR events nationwide. Join the Big Engine Freaks Friday, April 12th at 8 p.m. Players Grill, where the neighborhood meets.
Electricians, innovators, and tech enthusiasts, listen up. Miller Electric is shaping the future, and we want you to be a part of it. From healthcare and data centers, corporate offices, aviation, and industrial facilities, Miller Electric is powering the most exciting projects in Jacksonville and beyond. We offer not just a job, but a thrilling career with great pay and incredible benefits. Visit us at millercareers.com to apply. Miller Electric, where your skills meet our vision and equal opportunity employer.
The 2024 draft is almost here.
The Jaguars are now on the clock.
Join us at Evermank Stadium Thursday, April 25th for the official Duval draft party presented by Donovan Air Electric and Plumbing. Be there as the Jaguars make the 17th overall pick, and don't miss the unveiling of the official 30th season logo that you voted on. We're getting the party started at 7 p.m. Tickets are free, so register today at jaguars.com/draft party. We can't wait to see you there.
The Jacksonville Jaguars select...
Hey folks, Rick Ballew here for John's Auto. They've been a staple in Jacksonville going all the way back to 1985. At John's Auto, they service all makes, all models, cars, trucks, diesel, you name it, they do it. Whether it's routine maintenance or a complete engine overhaul, call John's Auto on Arlington Road. That's 904-743-3857 or go to johnsautomotivejax.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Don't look now, but here comes Scottie Scheffler.
It's incredible.
Because of course here comes Scottie Scheffler.
I mean, he's never in trouble.
I mean, it's just, it's incredible how he might three-putt from 9 feet, but everything off, I mean, driving the ball, his approaches, it's just pristine.
The Bryson DeChambeau, if you've been following along all day long, the LIV golfer, the one-time tour player, is leading the golf tournament. He shot a 7-under par 65 today. Denny Willett also is in the clubhouse with a 4-under par 68 There's other golfers still on the golf course around 3-under, 2-under, the like. John Rahm is at 1-under. But Scottie Scheffler, because of course he is at 6-under par. He's the only guy challenging DeChambeau, and he's got two to play. He's on the 17th hole right now. Scottie Scheffler is the best player in the world, and if he wins, and I'll say it again, I said it to Lee, I said it to you, if he wins again, and he would have two players and the Masters.
And two Masters, yeah.
And two players and two Masters. Wow. Just amazing. It
with
would really be amazing.
Three more majors to come in the next 3 months.
Right.
Where, I mean, it doesn't look like he's going to fall off.
I mean, he's at 6-under par, and he is, I mean, he's one shot off the lead and with two holes to play in day one. One shot off, let me rephrase that, one shot off a very impressive lead. It's
right.
Not like they're all scuffling, and he's scuffling the least. The two guys that have played the best, DeChambeau and Scottie Scheffler, on what looks like a gorgeous day there, have been fantastic.
And it makes you wonder. I mean, it's still just there's still an hour and a half left of daylight today. For it makes you wonder if you're still on the course and you see Scheffler at 6-under already. Do you start to press? I mean, it's day one. You don't want to. But the way that he's been playing, if you see Scheffler at 6-under, again, you know he's not coming back.
Right.
So it's almost like you've got to summon great golf immediately, and that can lead to mistakes.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing stuff. So we'll continue to track that for you. Tomorrow we'll be live in Gainesville. Freddie Wiebe from Florida Victorious will stop by. The NIL, they certainly have been a sponsor of our radio station of late. Shane Matthews, my buddy, is going to come by, I hope. So we'll talk a little college football with him. We'll be live at Spurrier's getting you ready for the Florida spring game. I'm certainly looking forward to that. Haven't been in Gainesville in a while. I'm looking forward to it. It'll be a lot of fun.
It should be. It should be a lot of fun. And, again, it'll be interesting just to – obviously there'll be optimism because it's spring. But, you know, what kind of insight do you get from the – you know, about the Florida defense? How is it really gone? I mean, now they're at the end of spring practice. They're obviously not going to do – today will be the last day of consequence. Tomorrow will be, I would imagine, very light or just off. And then they'll have the orange and blue game, and then that'll be a wrap. So we should have a very good idea of the progress that's been made.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see. The Florida orange and blue game comes up on Saturday. We'll be at Spurrier tomorrow. Folks, that's our program. Don't go anywhere, though. Rick Beluga's into the night right now. We're out of here. For Hayes and JJ, I'm Frank Frangie. Have a great night.